Welcome back. Did you do the last exercise and make a recording? If not, I really encourage you to do it. It will help you remember what you've learned so you can apply it later. Okay, moving on. In the next couple of tutorials, I'm going to go over some things you need to do and know right after you record, but before you get into the meat of editing. Now, I know some of you are going to want to skip ahead, but I think that taking the extra minutes to watch these two tutorials will give you a big advantage in both comfort and ability when we move on. That said, if you've used video creation software before, you can probably skip on to the next tutorial that covers what everyone should know before editing, but definitely watch that one. Now, when you complete a recording, the editing interface will open up, and you'll notice that your recording is in three places. First of all, it's over here in the media bin, where all of the video, audio, and images you'll use in your project go. It's here in this main area called the canvas, where you change how your video looks to your viewers at one point or frame in time. And it's also down here in this area with the tracks called the timeline, where you control what appears at what time in your video. I'll give you plenty of examples of these areas throughout this course, but for now, I'll show you some of the basics. To add items to the media bin, such as, say, a title image, just right or control click somewhere in the bin. Now, as a side note, you can access a majority of the most important functions in Camtasia via either the right control click menus, the main menu, and keyboard shortcuts. Pick whichever is best for you. So, we right click in the media bin and choose Import Media, browse to the file, and click Import to add it to the media bin. A few more tips about this area before moving on to the canvas. To preview a clip, click on it and watch it in the preview area at the top. You can scrub or view quickly forward or backward by moving your cursor towards the right or left in the preview. Also in the media bin area, you can access annotations, where you find callouts, arrows, text, blur, etc., transitions, animations, and other effects to add to your video. Just as with media, you can click on any of these and see what they look like or do in the preview area. All right, let's move on to the canvas and timeline. This area here, as I mentioned before, is the canvas. When something on the canvas is selected, it gets these circles at the corners. Drag them to scale or resize the media or annotation. Drag anywhere else on it to move where it is. And drag this small circle by the center to rotate it. One thing you may have noticed while I was scaling and moving this clip around were these yellow lines. They show when the media you're working with is either centered, like this, or aligned with something else. They're essential to make sure it's all the way at the edge of the video's boundaries. I'll cover more about the canvas in the next tutorial. And finally, let's go down to this area below, the timeline. The rows, or tracks, keep your media organized and allow you to show many things at once, like your video, images, and annotations. If your video does have audio, or if you have an audio clip, you'll see the top half of the waveform, which essentially represents how loud it is at different times. This gives you good visual cues about when you're talking and when you're not. This triangle and line are the playhead. They mark the moment or the frame that's currently being displayed on the canvas. If any of your media clips overlap on the canvas, the clip that's on top in the timeline will also be on top in the canvas. You can change this order by just dragging clips up or down. And that's it for this tutorial. Download the example project, or use what you've just recorded, add something to the media bin. If you're hard-pressed to find something, I provided a title slide. And take a moment to play around in the editor. Then come back for the next tutorial. See you then.